Hello, fifth graders. Happy March 4th. This is a special day. March 4th is the only day of the year that is also a sentence. It's a complete sentence. March 4th. Of course, it's written this way, March 4th, like go forth, but we can think of it as a sentence. It's a very special day, and I wanted to share it with you because I am your word work teacher. And your grammar teacher. So, March 4th, fifth graders, keep going, keep on. I know we're going through a tough time, but March 4th, put your best foot forward and keep going. I believe in you, fifth graders, you can do this. Also, this is the only day that gives encouragement. March 4th, happy March 4th. Great, now we've been working on some really awesome idioms. We learned hold your horses, to wait, to be patient, to hold on, use for telling someone who is getting ahead of themselves to please stop and consider their action or decision. Get under your skin means to be irritating, to bother a person, to annoy someone, to provoke someone. If you're at the end of your rope, it means you're in a state of not being able to deal with a problem or difficult situation any longer. Now, hit the road, hit the road. It doesn't mean literally to hit, like in this case, a baseball player is hitting the ball. Here's an actual road. It doesn't mean to literally hit the road, but it means to leave a place or begin a trip. So sometimes we say, let's hurry and get in the car. We've got to hit the road before there's a lot of traffic. Okay. In the Watsons go to Birmingham, the Watsons hit the road to Alabama with Mama's plan on when to stop, what to eat, and where to spend the night. But Dad had a plan in mind to drive as long as he could. So they hit the road on their road trip. We're working on the suffix -ness, which means state of. So we learned effectiveness, the state of being effective. Weakness, the state of being weak. Awareness, the state of being aware. These are all nouns. Today we have the word heaviness. Heaviness. And I have two definitions for it here. So the state of being heavy in terms of weight is what heaviness means. Like, the heaviness of the box made it awkward to carry and I needed help. So it could be heaviness in terms of the weight of something. But it is also a strong feeling of sadness or worry because it's like very heavy, right? Like when a situation is heavy, it's a mental heaviness. It weighs on you. It elicits a strong feeling of worry, sadness, distress. So the heaviness of the bombing at the 16th Street Baptist Church really affected Kenny, his family, and everyone in Birmingham. And really, it's still an event that people talk about now, even after all these years. So there's a great heaviness about it, especially because those four young girls died and many people were hurt. And, you know, Why would such a thing happen? How could such a thing happen? Is what makes it so hurtful and distressful. Like it makes us feel something. We're affected by it. Okay, so there's heaviness in it. This word is also appropriate now during a pandemic. There's a lot of heaviness in our world with everything going on, but we continue persevering. We keep going, fifth graders. We're all going through a hard time and, you know, we're all in it together, which makes me feel hopeful because I'm hopeful that things will continue to improve little by little. At least it's what I'm hoping. So know that we're all in it together, okay? We got to keep going. We've got to stick together and persevere. Now, we're working on the Latin root seed. Seed, ses, which means to go, to yield. To yield means to produce a result. So if you yield results, you get results. So hopefully, let's say when you when people bake, let's say you bake a box of cupcakes, and it usually yields 24 cupcakes, two dozen cupcakes. It's what it yields. It produces 24. Okay. Now we learn proceed to continue to do something that has already been planned or started. To concede means to admit something is true or correct, although you wish it were not true. To admit you are not going to win a game or argument. A process is a series of actions that are done in order to achieve a particular result. Today we have the word exceed. Exceed. Again, concede means to go. This word exceed means to be more than a particular number or amount. So to go above a particular number or amount. So like this word, this image says exceed expectations. So we know, fifth graders, that you will exceed our expectations when it comes to SBAC time. We know that you will try your best and you will exceed the expectations. Okay. Let's say we're having a fundraiser and let's say our goal is, you know, $1,000, but we raise $2,000. We exceeded the goal. We went above the goal. So hopefully you have exceeded, met or exceeded the goal for AR. Maybe you have 110% or 120%. That means you exceeded the goal. You went above the goal. Dad exceeded the limit in terms of the number of hours everyone thought he could drive without a break. So we know that Dad exceeded the goal. He really wanted to drive straight through without having to spend the night and spend money, and he was able to do that. So he exceeded the family's expectations in terms of how long he could drive. Okay, fifth graders, so great job. Keep on.